Hello, my name is Brandon Beal. I'm an R&B singer from Tyler, Texas, but I made my big break in Copenhagen, and now we're going to...
That should be the introduction.
We can be golden, why don't we show them all of the life there's meant to be? We can be golden.
We met in a basement bar.
Basement bar.
And I thought he was an asshole. And Brandon's like, I moved here because my manager Laza is here. And I'm like, dude, Laza who owns this bar? And he's like, yeah, that Laza, he's my manager. And I'm like, dude, he's my manager.
Exactly. Yeah, now nigga living life. You can be anything you wanna be, but nothing comes easily. Well, we've only done it twice.
Well, haven't you played them in some club shows anywhere yet?
Yeah. But those aren't comparing to the two times we've done it together.
Is that because you miss me?
Yes, I miss me.
Don't leave me hanging, bro. Brandon broke his neck and then he started selling crack and then he decided to move to New York like his brother and write songs. I was a classically educated soprano soloist that day.
He was in the boys' choir
when I was
9 years old.
And then
8 years old.
But then I walked down a dark road of importing containers full of weed. And then I started writing songs. You can be anything you wanna be. Well, Oliver, we've made a bunch of songs together. We wrote Better Than Yourself together, Strip No More together, Don't You Worry About Me, we wrote together.
We also wrote a song, on my album, Taking It Slow and Golden. And a bunch of songs that have never been released. We can be golden,
why don't we show? Well, of course, I like singing with you in Østerbro Stadion and in a forum because it's the first time we sang a song we wrote together.
Yeah, the hype and the high on me not seeing this guy for a long time. And the first time we saw each other backstage and it was for like 3 seconds, like, hey, I'm going to the stage. Hey, what's up, bro? See you on stage. You know, and then 45 minutes later, it's just like, and it just went bang, 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 bang. But then after seeing the videos and all that, it was just like...
It was pretty cool.
Big crowds, man. Record-breaking numbers. 20,000 people. You gotta do what you gotta do, yeah. And I think that you feel like a sense of confirmation. It's like you have this song and in your head you think like, oh, this is crazy, this is
really good.
This is really good. And you never really know until it's out. And then once it's out...
You walk up on a stage in front of 20,000 people and they don't sing it back? Maybe it wasn't that good.
No. So you have to have this sense of confirmation. So you confirm, like, okay, we were right. This was a great record. Look, I'm finally in first place. Should have been there in the first place. Runner up is the first to lose. He's an amazing cooker. Did I say cooker?
Well, so I'm basically the stove now?
He's an amazing cook. So every time that you go to this guy's house for dinner, you're going to eat great food. Very, very easy to work with because he's very good with words.
Okay. You could also have said terrible to work with because he's good with
words.
Well,
good to work with me. And that leads to the third one. A very real, very honest guy. Family driven. His knowledge, you know, his wisdom. You can learn a lot of stuff from this guy.
A lot of insignificant facts come out of
his
mouth. Sure. The first favorite thing about Brandon is his humor and laughter, which fills the room instantly when you're with him. No matter what you say in a writing session, it's never a negative thing, even though that I am hating the lyrics or the melody, or then let's go in a different direction, and it's not a problem. I also like Brandon's feet on the ground. When Brandon's family's been here, it's always been super cozy. When I go to Texas, if I'm anywhere near any of Brandon's family, they show up for shows and bring barbecue and stuff. And then I like the American spirit that Brandon brings to the table. And the last thing that I really, really like about Brandon, it's like a freight train. There's nothing that really stops Brandon. There isn't a boundary that says, oh, but the last song I released was a bit gimmicky and was about Twerk It Like Miley. Now I can't release a deep song about how I grew up and how I came up on top called Golden.
But we push us. We push each other.
You're a diverse motherfucker.
I always repeat this whenever I'm in radio interviews, something that Lucas told me a long time ago. It was like, work hard, expect nothing. if you answer that question and you're just like, well, I plan on doing this and I plan on doing this, da 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 da, most of the times it doesn't happen. So that's the future plans.
Lunch.
Lunch. 'Cause now we standing no time.